Good evening, everyone, and welcome to tonight's episode on Pioneer Generation. This is just going to be a very informal chat before the live show starts at 9 p.m. It's going to warm up everyone. We'll get into the specific issues later. I think we'll start off with basic reactions to the Pioneer Generation package, and most importantly, introduce everyone who's going to take part so you all get to know who is going to be in this discussion.
As you probably will be able to see on your screens right now, the Speaker of Parliament, Madam Halima Yaacob, who chairs the People's Action Party Seniors Group. Everyone say hello to Madam Halima. Next to me here is the Chief Executive of Runzi Hospital. Sorry if I'm just butchering the name there. Runzi Hospital, Lo Shuqing. Shuqing, welcome.
Thank you.
We're joined online by Isaiah as well. Are you hearing us, Isaiah? And
yes,
and someone, Isma, someone, are you there?
Yes, I'm hearing you.
Okay, so this is for everyone, just to keep the conversation lively, and when we go live on Channel 5 afterwards, we'll try and pick up on some of the points that you're making in this part of the program, okay? So about 10 minutes of online stuff, and then we're live to Channel 5 at 9 o'clock. And just keep everything lively and keep your remarks as brief as possible, but you know, don't wait for us to come to you if there's something you'd like to contribute to the discussion or make an observation about someone else who's made a point. Please go ahead, all right? Don't wait to be called in that sense. Is that all right with everyone?
Yes.
Okay, let's start with what the response has been so far. I mean, the Pioneer Generation was announced before Sunday, but it was on Sunday when we heard the details of who would qualify and what specifically might the Pioneer Generation be looking at broadly. What has been the response so far, Madam Halima? You must have spoken to your residents and your constituents. What have they said?
Well, generally, the response has been very positive. In fact, we also had, I brought together some of our chapters, the BAP Seniors Group chapters, about 25 of them or so, and we had a discussion. Response was positive. They really welcome this move. They see that this is an acknowledgement, recognition of the contributions on the part of our pioneers. And so I think they're really also waiting for the details to come out in the budget statement on Friday, next Friday.
I would have thought that some of them might have been consulted in the early going as to what they thought they might want to look forward to when the announcement was finally made.
Well, I'm sure the government must have consulted so many groups in the run-up to the announcement of the package as to what they think are the most important areas. For the PAP Seniors Group on the 28th of January, in fact, we had a dialogue session with about more than 100 participants. And so they came up with some suggestions. And I think they look at so many different areas. As you know, when it comes to seniors, the pioneers, there's so many areas that we can cover. But they felt that healthcare must take top priority because it's recurrent. And then as you grow older, you consume more medical services. Costs are going up. So they felt that healthcare should be the top priority.
Right.
Saman, you're one of the pioneer generation. What has been your reaction to what the Prime Minister announced on Sunday?
Okay, I was very glad when I hear that they're going to top monthly on yearly on our Medisave, and also they're going to pay for the insurance and to allow us to use our Medisave for more on our visits to the poly. I'm happy and pleased with the idea, but the detail is still not out. I hope that the amount is quite substantial.
What would be substantial to you? What's your definition of substantial?
After, let's say for the moment, I'm only allowed $400 from my Medisave to pay for the bills, but I hope it can be doubled to maybe 800 to 1,000.
Shuqing, would that kind of amount make a difference to the patients that you see and generally in the healthcare sector?
Well, I think this Pioneer Generation package generally is a good thing overall, because it does help to defray some of the medical costs. And it's not just for the pioneers, but also, you know, I think it's a relief for the caregivers and the children of the pioneers, because that's certainly something that they know that will help them as well. But for the people that I see, generally a lot of them already have a lot of subsidies, and for them, they actually MediSave doesn't really cover long-term care. Mm. So we could do with more, you know, in that area as well.
I'm sure we'll get much more into your experience in the Home Nursing Foundation, where you received, you spent quite a bit of time, right? Mm-hmm. And whether the schemes that have been announced would be covered under those kinds of care. And I'm sure we'll, you have something or two things to add about that.
Definitely.
Isaiah, what was your reaction to the key points that were announced in the package?
I think it was great. The package coming through for seniors, especially those that helped build Singapore, was really very well received. And speaking of different seniors, they welcomed the package as well. And it's something that I would really applaud the government for taking that step moving forward for such a huge number of seniors as well.
Yeah. I think Xu Qing mentioned about the knock-on effect, for example, caregivers would welcome this. And so Isaiah, from the segment of population that is the younger ones who might have family members who are pioneers, I don't know if you would come under that category, but what has been their sentiment from your judgment?
Yeah, I just want to draw from one situation that just happened. In fact, my fiance's grandma was just in hospital, and she is in the pioneer generation. Mm-hmm. And I think if such a package were to come forth, it would be really helpful for the family. And of course, for the people that we serve, the grandchildren, because healthcare would, if the parents can't take the load, maybe even the grandchildren, people my age, would need to shoulder the load as well. So this would definitely be welcome.
We were talking about details, for example, being widely or, you know, eagerly anticipated. Has your fiance's family kind of expressed what kind of details in terms of healthcare coverage would help them?
So far, we have not spoken to such details yet. But even for our generation, subsidies of any kind for healthcare would shoulder a load for the things that we could need to spend. For example, like housing, preparing to get married. Housing is one big issue that money will be well spent in those areas.
Mm. Someone, you were keen to look at the quantums and the average household spend on things like healthcare and what seniors will be able, or the pioneer generation will be able to avail themselves of. You want to add some more on the money side, and what proportion of, you think, the average? Yeah, what kind of help would you like to see specifically?
I would really like to see more help go into, of course, home visits from therapists, step down care, and of course the area of clinical supervised exercise programs. For example, people with diabetes or people who just had a cardiac surgery, getting their rehab. Subsidized.
One second, Isaiah. Someone, I just want to get you in here on this. Same question for you. What would you like to have seen specifically, in addition to what has already been announced?
Look at it as there should be more subsidies, as I mentioned earlier, to the visit to the polyclinic, to the specialist, when you have to pay the huge bill.
Yeah.
So I'm looking forward to that. Maybe more should be given to the elderly group.
Yeah. I'd like to throw this out because we are talking about subsidies. When we say subsidies, do we think that there should be more of the same subsidies, or should there be new kinds of subsidies for what is not being subsidized now? Madam Halima, your thoughts on that?
Well, actually, for the pioneer generation, the package provides additional subsidies. As you know, for instance, if you go to the polyclinic today, for those who are 65 years and above, they get additional subsidies already. And then they get the GST vouchers, you know, for medical, for the MediSave top-up. So they already have these additional benefits. Mm. So the pioneer generation package provides them the additional layer of subsidies in recognition of their contributions. Mm. So we are talking about new subsidies here.
Oh, that's
right. You think this ought to make most people happy?
Well, I think it will relieve a little bit. It will relieve some of their burden, as we heard from Isaiah, from family point of view.
So
members of the household, and then release their resources for other needs. You see, which is really important.
Go along with that,
Absolutely. One of the biggest worries of anybody who grows old is that there'll be a burden on the family. Mm. And the reason why they feel there'll be a burden is because of the cost of medical care that they will have to incur. And so, you know, having MediSave and MediShield actually helps a lot. Mm. However, as you grow older, I just want to add this point, that as you grow older, the premiums go up a lot. Yeah. So what I'm really looking forward to, and you know, it's anybody's guess, that is that the Pioneer Generation package will cover these premiums because it can be very substantial, especially if you're in your 70s and 80s.
Yeah, it becomes quite steep when you're above, you're 81 years old and above. Yeah. But I think the assurance given is that MediShield Life, a significant portion of the premiums
will cover. I'm
going
to ask you to hold that thought. We are going to be live on Channel 5 in just a few seconds. So everyone, just keep those comments lively and jump in, and we'll see you nice and smiling in just a few seconds. Everybody okay with that?
So what would you say is your defining contribution as one of the pioneers in your generation?
In my case, I can say that I have done a lot. And that was the reason I received my medal. Because without me and my officers, Singapore will not enjoy its current political stability. Because from the 50s to the 70s, we fought against the Communist United Front. They were preying on the poverty of the people. I spent my major years of my career in the special branch and later the ISD until 1970, when Lee Kuan Yew asked me to become the commandant, the vigilante corps, with the sole purpose of setting up the civil defense force from a nucleus of 30 Char Kway type of men, and see how the civil defense has grown.
The government is honouring the contributions of pioneer Singaporeans with a special healthcare package.
Should companies and society follow suit in showing appreciation? And in what ways? Find out right now on Voices Today.
Good evening, I'm Derek Paolo, here with my co-host Will Xavier. Tonight, Voices Today pays tribute to the pioneer generation of Singapore.
They were the cohort whose sacrifices made everything today in modern Singapore possible. Tonight, you'll read or hear about the individuals who struggled to build a life in a young, vulnerable nation. Mothers, fathers, lorry drivers, soldiers, even a labourer who helped build Changi Airport.
Many had little access to higher education and were trapped in low-wage jobs. Today, their savings have run low in the face of inflation. Illness is their main enemy and medical costs their biggest worry.
As Singapore turns 50 next year, the government is honouring their contributions with a Pioneer Generation package to help with their healthcare needs. But can all of us do even more? Time to meet our guests in studio, Madam Halima Yaacob, who chairs the People's Action Party Seniors Group and is the Speaker of Parliament. Welcome, Madam Halima.
Thank you.
To see you. And nice to see Chief Executive of Rinte Hospital, Lo Shu Ching. Welcome, Shu Ching. In healthcare for 2 decades, it says here, and including as former General Manager of the Home Nursing Foundation. I want to come back to that later on in the program, okay?
Sure.
We also want to hear from you at home tonight. Call us at 669-11020 or tweet us with the hashtag VoicesToday. You can also go to tdy.sg/VoicesToday to take part in our poll or post your comments. Joining our discussion tonight on Google Hangout, we have Mr. Saman Ismail. He's 65 years old and was one of the first national servicemen. He served with Singapore prisons for many years and now works in security. We also have Mr. Isaiah Cheng, 31, founder of social enterprise ProAge, which promotes geriatric wellness.
But first, let's hear from another pioneer Singaporean who remembers the early years of NS. Watch this.
Those who were born after 1947 were perforced by law to do national service. Not too many are happy because, one, a delay in going to the varsity. Some may really need financial assistance because our pay then was only $60 per month. Can you imagine? After completing your O-levels or your A-levels and you are only paid $60? So it's quite trying and quite challenging actually for the low-income families to have their son serve national service. If we didn't have a national service army to protect Singapore and to ensure Singapore's long-term survival, could we have today 6-7 universities, the CTE and all the flats, Sentosa? There are a few areas perhaps we could consider helping the pioneer generation. For reasons then, probably they didn't have a proper diet, good medical advice, probably, good medical treatment. And in the process, by default, they become weak and frail if and when they are admitted and they are physically disabled. They should be given priority. Jump queue, not wait 3-4 hours to see a doctor.
Tonight, we'll be bringing you tributes to pioneers like him submitted by readers of Today. 450,000 pioneers will benefit for life from the package. And now that the government has set the lead in giving them special recognition, let's talk about how the private sector or the community might follow suit. Madam Halima, the government has set the tone. Can others step in now?
Well, I certainly think everyone can do their part because government says that the main thing about the package is to recognise to the sacrifices and contributions that the pioneers have made. So in like manner, I think everyone can do their part, the community, the private sector. I really like the idea if I, you know, for the private sector to join this whole thing, to honour the pioneers by giving them discounts, rebates. You know, I think that would be really good because then it becomes a whole of society effort where everyone then recognises the contributions they have made. I think that would be really good.
Saman, time to name your wish list. Tell us what you think organisations can do for you specifically. What would you like to see?
There's a few things that I was thinking about. One of the things was maybe organisation like the NQC could give the Pioneer Group vouchers so that they can purchase groceries or items at the supermarket at a discounted price. And I was also thinking maybe for the MRT and bus fare should also be given to us at a discounted fare. Maybe entrance to sports complex or the sports complex, gym, community club will be subsidized or given a discount. This is what I'm looking for the agencies to give us.
Thank you very much. I think we can sort out some tickets to the zoo for someone. And Xu Qing, besides direct measures for the pioneer generation, what do you think companies might be able to do and work with organisations such as yours in paying back to the pioneer generation, a sign of token appreciation, as it were? These need to be meaningful.
Yes, I mean, certainly more companies can come in and volunteer and participate in activities that we organise for our seniors. And in fact, I know of some organisations that go in during Chinese New Year, for example, and clean the flats, participate in non-profit organisation activities as such. Work with the senior activity centres, for example, because what actually seniors and people in the pioneer generation really, really want are to be able to socialise more. You know, because what they're most afraid of...
Quality of life beyond healthcare.
Exactly. Just wellness, right? Yes. Because what they're most afraid of is loneliness, helplessness, you know, and boredom. And if we can, you know, get the private sector involved and bring in things to work with and to, you know, create more activities for them, that'll be great.
Let's bring in Isaiah on this because you work to help craft companies' corporate social responsibility programs for the elderly. Is there a growing interest among companies to help the elderly?
We just started last year. We help companies to structure their CSR programs, and our beneficiaries are definitely the older people and of course the non-profit organizations that serve the elderly. So far, we don't really have much companies coming forward to us, and when we share about, you know, we are going, our beneficiaries are the seniors, they're like, I rather have kids or this maybe something else. I'm not saying that we should de-emphasize on kids or orphanages, but I think more companies should step forward. Even usually when I tell my clients that you are getting old as well. So why not step forward to do that? And that's the whole key. I think also agree what Su Jin has said about more activities for the older adults,
yeah.
To improve their quality of life, not just to have them fed or well kept, you know, but emotional, psychological well-being is so important because oftentimes I hear seniors telling me they don't have the will to live, they'd rather die.
Right.
It's not because they don't have enough food, but it's just they feel lonely, they're depressed, and there are a lot of things that we could do and things that ProAge is really trying to push as well.
Thanks very much. Hold that thought. We'll have much more when the show continues in just a bit. What more can or should the government do for the Pioneer Generation? We looked at what people were saying on social media about the elderly and key emotions of sadness, warmth, pity. All these seem to well up. Time for a break. Tweet us with your views or call us at 669-11-020 if you want to share on air. Don't go away. Voices Today will be right back. Bill Teo, give us an idea of what conditions were like back in the early days.
Jobs were hard, definitely hard to come by. People were really trying to make do with everything they can.
Mm.
You remember the people driving pirate taxis, the old lady, the old man collecting cardboard to sell and that kind of thing. And then I saw in Hokkien Street where people were waiting for you to finish your food and to take away your leftovers, and down the road they're feeding their grandchildren. Those are scenes that our young will never be able to appreciate that we had those times.
Yeah. So beyond this Pioneer Generation package, Bill, what more do you think could be done for your generation, either by the government, the private sector, or any organisation?
In this respect, I would fully agree with what President Tony Tan said, that not only the government can do this, but every sector of society, in one way or another, in their own way, if they can propose something, it will definitely make us feel very appreciated and not forgotten.
It's nice to talk to Bill there, as you heard Bill say what more he was thinking should the government do for the Pioneer Generation. And to that point, Dawn Loy joins us by telephone, writing to us about her uncle Ah Seong, who is 84. You say, Dawn, that Ah Seong came to Singapore around 1965, a construction labourer until 1990. One of the things he helped build was Changi Airport, which everybody knows. Today, he's in frail health as a result of hard labour. Dawn, what are your hopes for him?
Okay, now at this old age, currently he needs regular medical follow-up and physiotherapy at hospital. My hope is that hospital can provide transport arrangements for his visits. Also, he's on medical social assistance, but it doesn't cover expendables like diapers for his urine incontinence. A separate application, other paperwork is required. I hope help on this kind of necessity can be given without much hassle.
Madam Halima, before the show, I think we were talking about what Dawn was saying are her concerns for her uncle, which is whether you have additional subsidies, the more of the same as to what is being given now, or do you have new subsidies as part of the Pioneer Generation package? Which direction should we be going towards?
Well, first we have to understand that for our seniors, those age 65 and above, there's already a layer of benefits that's additional to them over and above people of younger age. But on top of that, then we have the Pioneer Generation package coming in with the premiums, more support for the premiums under MediShield Life, greater top-ups under MediSave, and also for the more support, more subsidies for outpatient, specialist outpatient, polyclinic, and as well as the CHESS scheme, you see. So I think this is an additional layer. Already those age 65 and above Singaporeans, they have more subsidy, and then the Pioneer Generation package will give them additional support. So that we have to take note of. It's a little bit of confusion, but that is an important point that we have to take note of. And this will be 450,000 Singaporeans who are pioneers.
Yeah. The sort of thing that Dawn, our caller, was remarking on, Isaiah, what about those incidentals? Who's going to pay for those?
Currently, if I'm not wrong, CDC does provide some of these funds to pay for these expenses, because we do voluntary work and we meet people in the rental flats, and they do pay for that. Currently, but I think for the rest of the population, if most likely would be the family that covers it, and that's happens to most of the seniors that we serve currently.
In some cases, I mean, for those who are covered under public assistance, there is a special category of additional public assistance allowance for covering all this, the consumables, whether it is the diapers, milk powder and so on. For those not under public assistance, then you have also other, VWOs and also other schemes to support them in terms of the purchase of these items.
Yeah, certainly, it's certainly very helpful for, and for those who are already on assistance schemes, essentially, they are covered and they don't have to worry too much about their health care. But I think, as Will, you mentioned, we probably need to look at, rather than more of the same, I mean, it's great that we have more of the same, to expand the coverage. Because what Dawn mentioned about, the need to look at transport and consumables, that does, come up to quite a sum of money, even though it's little each time. And being in the ILT, in the intermediate and long-term care sector, I realise that these are the areas where people struggle most with, because we can't find any schemes to help them in these areas. So in the end, as a voluntary welfare organisation, we come up to help them in these areas.
I really understand that concern. I really hope now that for the pioneer generation, there's additional MediSave top up, perhaps whether there can be greater flexibility in the use of the MediSave. In a way, government tops up and then there's flexibility in the use for some of these purposes. I think that would be really useful as well.
Saman, do you agree with what Chu Ching and Madam Halima have been saying as to what actually will make the most difference from this Pioneer Generation package?
Okay, I agree to some of the things that you mentioned, but I was thinking more on long terms, because inflation keeps going up, and so the health cost is also rising in years to come. Will this premium subsidies will be a change, or will be according to in future? This is what I'm worried about, whether it's sufficient for the subsidy to cover our health costs and our visits to the clinics.
Imran Musa joins us by telephone. Imran, you probably remember a time, thanks for calling by the way, you remember a time when the families, in fact, the spouses of civil servants were covered under special benefit schemes. Remind us about what those were and why you think they've sort of disappeared over time.
The civil servants were the backbone of the government at that time, and because of the strong, clean and stable civil servant, that made what we are today. But if you look behind the scene, it's the wives at home who has been holding the family while the husband goes out to work and making sure that things are all okay. But upon retirement, if the husband passes away, no one takes care of the wives anymore. She doesn't get any benefits, any medical, nothing at all. And it is said that these are the people who are the unseen heroes of Singapore, but you do not take care of them the moment the husbands or the spouses pass away. I feel that the government should pay the highest tribute to all these people that has been working behind the scenes too.
Thank you for that, Imran. Madam Halima, what do you think of that?
Well, for those who are in the civil service, civil servants who are covered under pension, of course, their wife also benefit from the medical benefits under the old scheme. But for those who are not covered, because there were some changes along the way, and then they were given options, the older civil servants, the newer civil servants are all covered under CPF.
And following the loss of benefits following the passing of said civil servant.
So for them, there are the current schemes provided by the government to cover them, their spouses, if they are not working, if the children cannot take care of them. We have the 3M scheme, the MediShield, MediFund, and MediSave. So if they don't have MediSave, they don't have MediShield, then there is the MediFund to cover their needs, the medical needs.
I think we have received quite a number of letters from readers as well about the widowers of pensioners. And it brings us to this question of whether there should be distinctions as to who might get more in the Pioneer Generation package or whether it should be given equally. Isaiah, you know, from your perspective as a man in the street, what do you think? Do you think people want to see targeted help or given across the board?
I think most people would want to give wide help, but definitely, I don't think it's something that the government can shoulder alone. But that's why I think the targeted help would be good. But of course, for this package, is I would say that it's still pretty substantial because of the sheer number of people. But I think we need to really look at the key different areas of subsidies or being new subsidies or enhancing current subsidies targeted to people that really need them. And if there are any gaps for people that would deserve subsidies and need subsidies, and I think we should then look to address those gaps.
Yeah, we wanted to pick up on home nursing a while ago.
Yes.
Would you see that as being something specific that should be addressed directly?
I mean, certainly if, one of the things that the Pioneer, at the moment, the Pioneer Generation Package does not cover, or because MediSave does not cover it, is home nursing and ability to use your MediSave to do that. So if people, you know, and in fact, the whole of the long-term care sector, for example, nursing home, those who stay in nursing homes also, you know, do not get to benefit as much from this package just because you can't use MediSave for that as well.
Yeah. Right. Another 1 point, Suching, one has to bear in mind, for the needy elderly who goes into nursing home, there's already subsidies for them. They don't pay the full fees of those who are not needy, you see. So there's already subsidies for them if they're needy, low income, you know.
Yes.
I think we've heard that quite a few people are calling for more and, you know, certainly the wish list never ends.
That's right.
Is there a risk or do you get the feeling, Madam Halima, that while everyone lauds the Pioneer Generation package, it's also leading for people to say, I'm 55 to 64, I face the same problems, worries. I will be the same age as the Pioneer Generation soon. Can you also give it to me?
Derek, I have to go back to my first point, and that is there's already this level of subsidies that applies to everyone. Of course, the older ones get more, and then if they're in the Pioneer Generation, they get even more. So for those who are needy, they're 55 or 64, they already have this level of subsidies under the 3M scheme, you see. Yeah. So I think that one has to bear in mind. And even we are not talking about just healthcare, but also other areas as well, like transport, for instance. We do have the subsidized transport for those who are 60 years old and above, so it's a lower age. So I think, and we have to also be mindful of the fact that this package is a recognition. So
I think that's the most important thing. Which must probably be communicated, which is that this is a special recognition. It's one-off, it will last a lifetime for this group, but it is just for this group, and it's a question
it's a
of whether people accept that.
Yeah,
it's a special group of people.
We'll keep the conversation going. If you have any questions for any of our guests tonight, thanks everyone for being here today. I want to follow the continuation of this discussion. Join us online right now at tdy.sg/voicestoday. Don't forget to take part in our poll. Email your views to today's Voices pages. Catch our Encore telecast this Saturday at 1:30 p.m. We'll see you next Thursday for another live one.
Good night. Welcome back. The discussion continues after our live show. And Madam Halima, let's start now by looking at what your PAP seniors group is looking at beyond healthcare.
Mm-hmm. Well, beyond healthcare, of course, there are so many other different areas. One major area that people have constantly raised is this issue of employment. Because people say, look, if you're productively employed, engaged, you will make less use of healthcare. If you don't have a job, you're not occupied, you're more likely to fall sick and you're more likely to make use of healthcare. So employment is a major area. Government passed the re-employment legislation in 2012 and that has assisted somewhat. But I feel there's a lot more that can be done particularly on the part of the employers, to provide employment opportunities and to remove that negative mindset towards older people. So I think that's important.
Let's bring in Isaiah, because you work with the companies. Is there a mindset problem or issue that needs to be overcome when it comes to the elderly and their employment?
Most definitely. I think there's still pretty much a sentiment of ageism in Singapore, where we look at older people in a very different light. Oh, look at aging in a very different light. It's as if it will not happen to the younger people. And there has been that sentiment in the workplace, and the clients that we serve and the people that we meet often in the community as well, when I speak to older people, and even perspective of younger people. For example, at a workplace where seniors, they think that seniors may not be capable of doing more than what younger people could do. Or they would think, for example, seniors are meant to be on a wheelchair when they grow older. They're meant to be weak. So that's something that I would really like to see change. Mindset
how
change
are you personally
areas.
Countering the mindset that seniors are either less productive or more expensive to hire?
On our company itself, we hire seniors, and we train volunteers as well, senior volunteers to run exercise classes, for example. At the same time, we counter that by going to the corporates, and by doing CSR with corporates, we actually train professional volunteers among their workforce and through those experience they see aging in a different light, and feedback so far, they improve their relationships with their grandparents and their parents after going through some of the trainings that we do.
Saman, do you feel that ageism at play, is it greatest in the work at the workplace or beyond that?
Okay, ageism, when you are getting older, I think physically you are slower, weaker, but then your mind is still strong. You are an experienced worker. You can contribute more to the workforce. Especially now in the security line, I'm more experienced. I have 40 years of experience in the security line. I'm able to pass on this experience to the younger staff. Maybe physically I'm not as my younger days, but experience-wise, intelligence, getting the job done operationally, administratively, I can contribute more.
Yeah, and you can't put a price on the kind of experience you bring to any job in your field, right, Saman? I just wanted to talk about what everyone has been saying about this. We're all in this together, and the families of those beneficiaries of the PGP might also react positively to the benefits which accrue to you. What has been your family's reaction to something that has been designed, especially for you, Saman?
My family is very happy with the package that is given to the Pioneer Group. They did not say much about the thing, but they are looking forward to it. Maybe when the full detail is out, I think they will be more happy to see and receive all the subsidies.
The entitled mentality, which sometimes comes up in the course of the discussion on any given point, given that, you know, the scope, adding scope to the program might also increase the numbers of people that have to be dealt with or be covered under that program. So 450,000 and growing. How much further can it expand?
You have to ask the government that, because it's a matter of sustainability, as I understand what Madam Halima has said.
Madam Halima, you have mentioned about sustainability before. I think we were discussing during the break. It's not 45,000, you said it's 450,000. And you've mentioned how there are already safety nets in place. But that hasn't stopped readers from saying, you know, let's give more benefits. We had a reader who said, oh, why doesn't the HDB build dual key apartments, flats for, you know, multi-generational families, for example.
But they already have.
They have a 3G, 3-gen flat, but yeah, like, you know, a dual key like in ECs, for example. So that's just one example of what readers are asking for. Is it hard to run away from the fact that we might be relying more and more on the government, and when the government gives something like the Pioneer Generation Package, that will continue to foster a reliance?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes we have to bear that in mind. And of course, I'm sure that this is a point, sustainability and affordability. I'm sure that the Deputy Prime Minister, Minister for Finance, will address that point. Government must have done its sums very carefully, because this is not a one-off. It's going to be long-term and recurrent. But we also have to bear in mind that there are many other schemes already in place to support our seniors. For instance, when you talk about housing, we have the silver housing bonus of 20,000 if you move from a bigger flat to a smaller flat. So that goes into your retirement account, which you can use to have enhanced income for yourself. And then we also have the lease buyback, where you can give back some years of your lease to the HDB. You can live for 30 years in the flat, but you also have some income, you see.
Correct.
So there are various schemes that are available.
So in fact, you know, if you were to go through the entire list of schemes, I think you would have so many to list. And yet people seem to feel like as if not enough is being done for them. Why do you think that is the case? What? Especially the older generation, whether it's Pioneer, say 65 and above, or the 55 to 64 group.
Yeah, that's the reason why I think the PGP, Pioneer Generation Package, has really put healthcare as a priority. Because when we discuss with the pioneers group, our PAP seniors group, we discuss with the pioneers, we discuss even with the young, they say, yes, there are so many different things, but the most important thing in their view is healthcare. And therefore, they wanted the PGP to focus a great deal on healthcare. But that does not mean that the other areas are not important. I'm sure that the government will continue to review, revise the scheme as and when it is necessary in order to continue to enhance and improve quality of life of our seniors.
Younger Singaporeans like yourself, Isaiah, have often described as the entitled generation, me too, me too. While the PGP states that the entitled mentality is to be countered empowering the successful to give back, and also showing appreciation whose shoulders they stood on. You think that that's being achieved by what's been announced? Are we entitled, Isaiah?
I think for the seniors, they're totally deserving and entitled to such a package. Yeah. And I think that the scope is really scoped as a reward just for this generation. And I totally agree with that. For us, when we are born, for me, I'm in the 80s. We come into Singapore that is pretty much developed. We already have HDBs. We don't need to run around kampong and deal with many infectious disease and things like that. And so, definitely, it's something that I agree with. And for my generation, I don't believe that I would say that I deserve this.
Yeah,
compared to the generation.
Sure, which means, of course, that this is the kind of Singapore we want to have, showing appreciation for those who got us here. You think this does that?
Yeah,
is that where we want to be?
Yeah, because I think one of the sayings, it goes that you need to honor your elders and then you live a long life. And I think this is something that as Singapore, we are doing for the final generation, and definitely.
Saman, do you think that there has been a lack of appreciation for your generation until now?
Yes, I agree with that. Previously, before this idea was mooted or was implemented, there were very minimal given to us. We received our medal. We were offered jobs. Right. But other than that, the government did not give us anything.
Right.
So, what about from society? Do you think society has appreciated you, especially the younger generation?
Society? A younger generation? You mean for myself, I say?
No, as in for someone, how does he feel that, you know, perhaps the generation of Isaiah, those in their 30s or even younger, are appreciative of the work and contributions and the toil.
I can't see any forms of appreciation from them because it's not being shown. I don't see any appreciation to the senior group like us.
In fact, if I may add, and I think one of the problems may be that the younger generation may not even be aware of what the pioneer generation has done. So I'm glad that nowadays there's
some talk about
programs to actually let people know what had gone on in the 50s and the 60s. Mm. I think also for too long because Singapore was a youngish population. The idea of, you know, if only when you're productive, then you're appreciated, you know, had kind of seeped into our mentality. Yeah. So when you're old, you're non-productive, and therefore
respect for elders kind of
went away. But we are trying to bring it back.
I think if the Pioneer Generation Package has enabled this kind of conversation to take place, going beyond just in benefits, but rather the importance of recognizing our seniors, appreciating them. Like someone said, you know, he feels it's not so appreciated even by the younger generation. I think that's really wonderful. Because like what you said earlier on, Soo Ching, about the psychological support, you know, I think that's really important. You know, Isaiah said the same thing also. Yep. So everybody plays a role. And it's not just a question of how much they get, you know, benefits and so on, but how they feel that they're being respected and their dignity is being taken care of in this society is so important.
Is there a danger, Madam Halimah, that expectations have been raised high? When the details come out, some people might say, oh, that's not much more.
There will always be that danger because there will be some who will be expecting a lot, but some will say, okay, I recognize that, you know, I have got this now, but I'm getting more now. So we will have to contend with all the different expectations. Yeah. But I think most important thing is that the idea is that our older generation, our pioneers, will really benefit, you know.
These schemes tend to be set in stone before very long, you know. Memories die hard, don't they? Isaiah, by the time you get there in about 50 years or so, shouldn't you be in the we deserve category? Hey, you gave it to them. How about me?
No, as I mentioned, I don't think I will even dare to say that I deserve such a recognition.
Yeah.
As
You're
a
speaking
generation.
For yourself here, yeah?
Yeah, I'm speaking for myself. I speaking for myself as a 30 plus younger generation born in Singapore that's really good and cared for. So I think the entitlement we get from EduSave cheaper kind of going to school kind of rates is we are really, really thankful for that already.
Soo Ching, we were talking during the break that future seniors are going to be very different from our pioneer generation.
Yes.
Do you think that this current generation will recognize they are in a much better position than the pioneers who are therefore getting this help?
Certainly, I think I represent, and I am in the, you know, my parents are in the pioneer generation, and I recognize that I'm not. The opportunities that have been given to the next generation of seniors, you know, have been so much more. They're much better educated. They earn so much more. So I think the expectations will be different, and even the needs may be different, because nowadays, even in terms of healthcare, people seem to be, you know, they say that the 60s and the new 40s and so on and so forth. So people are healthier. So perhaps, you know, what we'll be looking for in the future may be different, and our needs may not so much be medical needs anymore.
I'm going to wrap things up by going around the table or around the internet first of all. With you, Isaiah, just what are your conclusions from all you heard today? And has the ball moved for you, as it were?
Definitely a much better holistic understanding of the package and different diverse views. But just a parting shot, I think more subsidies could be done for clinically supervised kind of programs that would promote knowledge and skills for people with chronic diseases. I think we can do more in those areas to prevent and treat such diseases. And I definitely agree that it's a great entitlement for that generation that has built Singapore.
Yeah. And I applaud the government for that. Let's go to Saman next. After this discussion, what do you think the future now is for you in the years to come? Has it changed? Has your vision of retirement, of your twilight years changed in any way?
Yes, I'm more positive towards the future. With all the subsidies and the package that are given to us, we are very thankful. And we believe that we can still resolve our healthcare and our financial constraints with the help that is given by the government. Wow. I wish to thank all of you.
Yeah.
This is something, a new experience for me.
Right. And can we say thank you for your service in the service of the nation? Thank you very much indeed. Mm-hmm. Are we down to the last item on your wish list, Xu Qing? And how close are we to crossing that one out, you think?
The last item on my wish list?
Yeah. Do you think we've got any closer to sort of in, dealing with the aspirations or hopes of the people that you serve?
Oh, yeah. I think one of the most important thing about the people I serve is again, really to recognize that, you know, they are important as well, even though, you know, they are frail and they are needy. This whole idea of the Pioneer Generation Package primarily helping, first of all, their healthcare needs and the needs of their own children and caregivers indirectly, but also secondarily, you know, to just basically have this conversation about how we should respect the elders out there, I think will be, you know, a very good step in the right direction.
Step in the right direction, Madam Halima.
Well, I'm the pioneers are really a very special group of people. I'm really very glad that they are now getting some relief in terms of healthcare, they and their families, you know, because they don't have money, much money, and therefore the burden on their families will be quite high. So now there's some relief. I think the challenge also for us will be how to reach out to the 450,000 and explain to them and their families how they can benefit from the package. Certainly there are areas which we've discussed, you know, where we can further improve, whether it is long-term care, whether it is consumables hitherto not covered or covered only for those who are under public assistance. Those are areas I think as we move along, are areas which we can look at how to further refine, and I certainly hope that would be done. But overall, I think I'm really glad that this is a good package for our special group of people. Yeah.
Well, the discussion doesn't just end tonight. Of course, when budget comes, we'll have the details of what's in the Pioneer Generation Package. So keep talking, keep thinking about these issues and other issues that matter. It's that's all for us tonight here at Voices Today. Have a good night. Thanks.